Hello learners, welcome from the studio of NIOS. I am Dr. Asha Singh, former associate professor from Lady Irwin College. Today our lesson is number 10, Care of Children in Early Years, and our topic is childcare settings. Now, childcare settings, what does it mean? It means all children don't grow up just in families. If the parents are working, they might be going and staying with their grandparents or with an uncle or aunt or in a neighborhood with an auntie who is running, who gets four or five children and she takes care of them. So there are many childcare settings. But for us, what is important is wherever children are growing, they must get the best care. We've been talking about in the lessons that early stimulation is necessary, children need to be fed, children need to be kept clean. So whatever kind of care children are in, we must ensure that children get the best care. Now, what does it show? It seems, no, that one child is in a home and the group of children are in a daycare setting or in a school-like thing from where they will be picked up when their parents come after work. It is a group, and it is important that within a group, all children get the attention that they need. It shouldn't always be children, come and sit, children, we'll do play now, children, play with blocks, children. Sometimes the teacher must address all different children by their names, because taking a child's name gives them a sense of identity. And they must also be sensitive to the different physical, emotional, and social needs that children need, and ensure that all children are comfortable, well-fed, and emotionally secure. So in the non-familial care, usually there are children in a group, and the caregiver must meet the needs and requirements of each child by way of being touched, talked to, and being sensitive to their feelings, and being able to smile, laugh, and feel emotionally secure. The caregiver must create an emotionally secure space. So therefore, family care or extrafamilial care, children's need are nutrition and healthcare, general well-being, playfulness, and playful caregiver, and all-around development opportunities. Here in the picture, you see children eating together. Now, this is a picture of a child, perhaps in the familial care, where the child is held, so the child is getting emotional security by feeling a sense of closeness, proximity with the adult caregiver, the child is being read to. We must ensure that such experiences are also replicated in the setting of the group care. So just as families create a schedule of care of babies in the home, there must be a schedule for the care of babies in the group. So when the children reach, there should be a well-planned program that basically provides loving care and opportunities for being together, social interaction, looking at different things, and in a very playful manner, learning. For young babies, learning is just not taking paper and pencil and learn alphabet and number, but do many things that foster all-around development. So let's see what a group care can do. Now here children are playing together, doing things together. Children are perhaps dancing together to music. The children are very small. They're all about 2 and 2.5 years old. But they're in a group, they look happy, they're doing things because there are lots of things to play, and there is freedom to play with things or play with each other. And that is what is an indicator that it is a setting which is comfortable for the child and comfortable in terms of the physical space that it provides. In the pictures, you can see it's a group setting and children are waiting to either hear a story or they're reading a book, or maybe the teacher is showing them different things. You know, a story can be told in many ways. Like, for instance, there is this Kavita who can tell you a story. मैं आज अपने घर से आई, मैंने बहुत सारा दूध पिया, ओ मेरा तो पेट भरा हुआ है. So you can use objects, you can use many different kinds of things where children will be able to concentrate. So a little bit of time for sit down activities is also very important. Here, many different kinds of, we've talked about auditory, we have talked about sensorial experiences of a variety. Here children are playing with water, perhaps somebody has come from outside and making them dance. And here they are playing outside, jumping on dry leaves or exploring the sounds of birds. So a group, you know, being away and being in out of family care can also be fun. But the child has to be comfortable. Oh, now what are they doing? They are outside in the sun. They're wearing new caps. Perhaps again a puppeteer came and made caps for them. And they are counting the shadows. They are kind of measuring their shadows. They are all together and having, exploring and doing things together. Here also, they are looking at the shadows. So, in a caregiving center, we must expose children to new experiences. Some of the experiences have to be continuous. Children like repetition of stories, repetition of songs. But they also like to play outside. Now, when we are looking at children in a group care, all that is important, that each child should get attention, each child should get, they also must learn to get along with each other. They must also remember that we have to wait for our turn. So in a group setting, a lot of learning about social sharing and caring for the other also happens. Now here, the other thing is that in our country, there are many, many different kinds of religions and lots of festivals and celebrations. So just as if the child was in the family all the time, the child would see the celebrations and the preparation. Some many schools also celebrate all the different kinds of festivals. Preschool years or the early childhood is also the time when children learn to do things with their hands. And here, what's this? It's a magician. So in a group, you can watch many adult performances also, which tells them, which kind of again generates a sense of motivation that when I grow up, I can also become a magician. I can also play a guitar. I can also tell stories. I can also teach about numbers and alphabets. So growing up has to be fun. Now, what are they doing? They're sitting together here in a exercise mode. And the teacher is also in the exercise position. An adult who does things which they want children to do requires them to do the similar things, sit in the same way, perform the same actions, and that is the best kind of learning. So if the parents are away, don't worry. If the parents have to work for whatever reasons, then, and you know, everybody needs to grow up with people. So here, group setting, if it is a planned program, it helps the children to form their schedules, routines, and be comfortable. Therefore, the caregiver has to be very trained. The caregiver has to know things, what children like, what they can do with the children, but also have a feel for childhood. And that feel and spirit of energy and warmth makes growing up in a group lots of fun. Similarly, growing up in a family is also fun. So wherever, whether the child is growing up in a family, growing up in a group setting, all that we need to remember is that children are learning all the time. Children want to do things. Children want to know new words. Children look at new things and want to know what it is. So they want an environment where there is talking, where there is different sounds, where there is love, where there is care. If the child is distressed, the teacher can go and say, come, 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 I'll tell you. If the child gets hurt, then come, I'll fix it. So that is what all the training for early childhood requires. A caring, sensitive, watchful caregiver. So let's just summarize. Care in group settings. In a group setting, if you have 40 children, how will you reach out and look at the needs of all the needs of the child. So adult child ratio has to be small for good care of children. Adults should watch and also allow for free movement. Children must do activities. They must participate. Active play and restful activities. All the time just jumping is not going to be helpful. A child gets tired also. So active play and restful activities build attention. Both outdoor and indoor activities are healthy. Exploration allows for building observation. Being in group care can be useful if done with care. Thank you.